This lecture is designed to discuss the basics of tariffs and trade barriers. Once we get it going here. So let's start first by explaining what a tariff is. A tariff is a tax. It adds to the cost of an imported good and is one of several trade policies a country can use. A tariff can be specific, such as a tariff of $10 a barrel on oil, or it could be based on percentages, such as 15% of all imported automobiles. These can have a significant impact on the demand for a good as they increase the price for the consumer. Tariffs and other trade restrictions, such as quotas, are often created to protect new industries in a developing country. They are also used in more advanced economies with developed industries. We see this in the U.S. The idea of using these restrictions is motivated by protectionism, to protect the domestic companies and their workers from foreign competition. The auto industry, for example, may support tariffs or quotas to allow U.S. automobile prices to remain below its imports, thus retaining a larger segment of the automobile market. This would also help with unemployment in a short-term view. Ultimately, this is not healthy for the economy, as it is not maximizing the concept of comparative advantage, which is producing what your country produces best relative to other countries. Another reason countries impose tariffs is to protect a developing industry, otherwise known as an infant industry. The government will levy tariffs on imported goods in the industry it is trying to grow. So, for example, if the country is trying to develop its electronic industry, it may want to discourage the import of rival electronics. Unfortunately, this also is not a good long-term strategy because if an industry develops without competition, it could wind up producing lower quality goods that will ultimately slow economic growth. Sometimes trade barriers are employed as a retaliation technique for political reasons. For example, the embargo against Cuba, which restricted all exports and imports between Cuba and the U.S. In a less extreme example, if France believed that the U.S. had allowed its wine producers to call sparkling wine champagne, a name specific to a region in France, for too long, it may levy a tariff on an import from the U.S. until the U.S. agrees to crack down on improper labeling. Often the threat of a retaliatory trade barrier is enough to create cooperation between two countries. The key thing to remember with tariffs is that the consumer price is always higher after a tariff, and consumers are always worse off. Tariffs also reduce efficiencies by allowing companies that would be viable in a competitive market that would not be viable in a competitive market to remain open. They slow the introduction of new goods and better technologies, and ultimately slow economic progress.